Okay, guys, so yesterday we talked about events that are mutually exclusive, meaning they cannot happen at the same time, right? Okay? So Dalton cannot be in this room and Mr. Fay being happy at the same time, right? Those would be mutually exclusive events. Okay? We did that red one up there. It says a box contains 3 glazed donuts, 4 jelly donuts, 5 chocolate donuts. We said that based on that setup, there's no description that a glazed donut was also chocolate or that a jelly donut was also glazed or something like that. So those were mutually exclusive events, okay? And when we deal with mutually exclusive events, okay, we ask the question what the probability is of the first event or the second event occurring. It is simply taking the individual probabilities of both events and summing them together. So probability of A or B is the probability of A plus the probability of B. Okay? Now, what I want you guys to hopefully recognize as we work through the next handful of probability questions that we see kind of at the high school, until you get to a stats class or probability stats in high school, there's like 5 or 6 questions that we can really ask you. Okay? But then we practice those over and over and over and over again. My hope is that you see that donut question is exactly the same as this question here. Okay? It says, at a political rally, there are 20 Republicans, 13 Democrats, and 6 Independents. If a person is selected at random, find a probability that he or she is either a Democrat or an Independent. Okay? Now, the thing that all these questions talk about is that the person was selected at random. And usually we talk about, like, closing our eyes. A lot of times, maybe, if we were to do a scenario like this, let's say that somebody walks into this room, and we're trying to see what's the probability of picking out a girl, okay? If the person that is walking in the room is a girl, they might be biased towards picking out a girl. Does that make sense? Okay? If it's a man that comes in, they might be biased to picking out a male, okay? So we always say that it's randomly selected because we want to eliminate bias. You remember throwing a dart and trying to hit an area? We close our eyes, right? Because that eliminates skill. And when we do that, it's kind of like when Lex bats. He closes his eyes,
right.
Okay? And it eliminates a lot of skill, okay? So when we do that, skill is the same thing as bias, creating bias, okay? It skews our probabilities. All right, here's what that means. It lends us one way than the other, okay? And that makes then our events unequally likely to occur. So that's an issue. So that's why we talk about randomly selected, okay? But it says at a political rally, 20 Republicans, 13 Democrats, 6 Independents. That structure right there tells you something about these events. Now, you might not know this, but at the time you turn 18 years old, you will register to vote. And when you register to vote, you will check a box on what party you align with, okay? Are you a Republican? Are you a Democrat? Are you independent, okay? Now, when you do that, okay, can I check both boxes for Republican and Democrat?
No.
Why
does it matter?
Okay, it doesn't matter, okay? But they ask that. They want that information from you, okay? When you do that, you cannot identify yourself as a Republican at the same time that you identify yourself as a Democrat. Does that make sense, everybody? So these events are mutually exclusive. They cannot happen at the same time. Now, you might be a Republican that on the last ticket you voted all Democrat. Or you might be a Democrat that voted for half the Republicans. Because there are Democrats that have Republican views, right? There are Republicans that have Democratic views, okay? That happens, okay? But when you register and you say that you align yourself with this party, you are that party, okay? It's like saying when you come to school and you're a sophomore, you're not a junior, right? Okay? Depends on what? Just because you were a sophomore twice doesn't mean you were a junior that second time, okay? So when you are in a class like those types of that structure, that hierarchy of classes, you cannot be in both. You cannot be in multiple classes. So these are mutually exclusive. Why do we need to know that? Because if they're mutually exclusive, there's the probability formula we're going to use. Okay? So the question is, what's the probability of randomly selecting a person and they either be independent or Democrat? Okay? So Democrat or independent is the event that we're interested in.